Are you looking for quality economic data for the United States? Maybe you're an investor looking to leverage the data for decision making, or you're a solo practitioner looking to use the data to support your own research. Well, today I'm going to show you how to get this data using the US Census API with Python. And make sure you stick to the end to get a sneak peek of an even easier way to obtain this data. My name is Ariel Herrera, your fellow data scientist with the Analytics Ariel channel, where we bridge the gap between real estate and technology. If you're new to the channel, please subscribe and like our content, as well follow us on social media. All right, let's get started. Today I'm going to go over an example of how to use the US Census Bureau API through the population segment of data that they have. I'm going to also go through different links within the US Census site, as it could be a little bit confusing for a beginner to sift through. And don't worry, I'm going to have all the links in the show notes for this video. So to start off, it'll be in the show notes. You need to sign up for a key. It's free to sign up for a key for the US Census. You could just put your full name, address, submit key requests, and in a minute, you'll be able to obtain your API key to access this data. And just taking a step back, why are we looking to access this data through an API? Well, it's a lot easier than managing different Excel spreadsheets, especially if you're looking to merge this with other data sets or with your own application. So what exactly is the US Census Bureau? Well, their mission is to serve the nations as a leading provider of quality data about its people and the economy. So it's a government source. So it's pretty reliable data. They obtain this data every year, very vast in what they actually collect, which you could also see at the bottom. They have information relating to population for broken out by housing, workforce, information on industry, geography, and a lot more, which is really cool. So what is actually available for us to get through the API? Because as a heads up, they don't have all their data that's available as an API. From what I see, it's a pretty good chunk of it. So on this site, they actually have the data sets. And the one that I'm actually interested in is the population estimate APIs. And this essentially gets current data on births, deaths, migration to calculate population changes year over year. I think there's even month over month. For this tutorial, we're going to be focusing on the last table down here called Demographic Characteristic Estimates by Single Year of Age and Sex. It's limited amount of variables and endpoints, so it's probably the easiest one to start off with. So within this, Census already gives us some documentation on how to call the API, different examples, variables, and an example call. Okay, so now let's go into the API call. And it basically gives us some sort of dictionary JSON response that tells us information on what this is. So you can see down here is the actual description, and I'm not gonna go through it, but if you wanna read it, feel free. But it still doesn't give us any indication of what to do next. So we would go over to examples, that second one. And this is going to bring us back just this table. We again have information like title, the description, and we also see down here examples. So if I click this, what's now going to show me is that there's different geography hierarchies. So if you want to see everything grouped by US, so the population for the US, a group by state, this is where you would actually find how to the right endpoint to get that data. All right, so say we want to work with getting all the population in the US. I'm going to copy this and go over to Jupyter Notebooks in order to enter this in. So I already have some information up here. This is just me loading in some libraries that we're going to be using. For pandas, which is the tabular sort of data, I want to be able to see all my columns, so I'm specifying that here. And then for the API keys, only one you need is the census one. And that one I'm just loading in from a CSV file. That way I'm making sure that everything's secure. And I'll show you what that function does in a minute. So let's pop this in, and we're going to put strings around it, quotes around it as a string, and we'll call it URL. So it says your URL, your key goes over here. So I'm gonna delete that, and I'm going to add in my key, which I called appear census API key. Throw that in here. I already have requests imported, which is going to allow us to actually call the API. So now I'm going to set an object called response, use that library request, the method request, and we want to get the data. So I'm going to pass the URL here, and there we go. We get the response, and it's 200, meaning that it's okay, no errors. So if we look at the text, we could see there's columns name, pop, US, then we see the values, which this isn't really that much in a friendly format. So what we could do is use this data frame or this function that I created above, copy it, and what's essentially doing is converting this data into a data frame, so a tabular format, so that's easy to read. So if I were to run this, a little bit cleaner, right? We could see what the population for the United States. Great, so now we have this data, but what are the other parameters or variables that we can work with? So if we go back here to where we had our table, we can click variables, and this is actually going to show us what variables are available for this API. And I'm going to show you how you can input different variables and what the values are. But let's go back over here, and we were able to get this data for the US, but what if we want to actually dive a little bit more deep? Maybe we want to see the data across multiple years. So if we go over here, we can see that there's a variable called date code, estimate date. If we click it, it actually shows us the different values we could use and what they refer to. I know this is a little bit not too friendly to look at. So if we actually go back to this table over here, or this page over here, we can actually click related information. And this gives us the variables and their corresponding values. So the date code, the one we just referenced, is over here. And say if we want to look at the last 5 years. So it would be 12, 11, 10, 9, and 8. Not the last 5 years as of the recording of this video, but of what they have on their actual website, what's current. So how do we do this? What we're going to do, I'm just going to put a note here, is we're getting the pop for US last five. And we're going to set our new URL. So I'm going to copy this exact one up here. And what's going to change is in the URL, we have get, and this refers to what columns we want to get, so name and population. And then we're saying for everything in the US, because we have a star there. But we also want to be able to get that date code. So if we add that in there, and now I'm just going to copy this, get a response here, and turn that into a data frame, we could see we now have the date code for multiple years. But this is, again, not that friendly to look at. So now let's add date description, which is one of the other ones that was in the variable list. And now we can see the description for each. But we don't want to see all of this. This is a little bit too much information. So if we go back to date code, we can do equals. And I think the ones we wanted were the last 5 years, starting at 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. Now what changes is this comma that we had here needs to now be an ampersand for and. And then the comma up here needs to be an ampersand as well. Now if we run this, we should get the data, but only for those five time periods. Next, let's say if we want to dive a little deeper and get the information by state. So let's do population, US by state. So if we go back up, we were looking at the geography hierarchy starting at the US, but now we want to look at the state. So if we actually copy this, we can bring it back to our notebook, type in URL, and we also want to put our key in there, so I'm just going to override this. And what's changed is we're still getting name, population, state, but now we're selecting all states because of that star there. So So I'm going to get the response for this, turn it into a data frame, and now we get it for every single state. So as you can see, we have name, pop, state, and that state column has 01, 02, 04. So basically every state has a corresponding two-digit string that corresponds to it. So what if we want to take a deeper look at some of these states, but not all of them? Well, I'm actually going to pop in this code that I had already written. And what we're going to be doing here is we just transform our data frame, so it's the same one below. We are going to be converting this pop column into an integer because right now it's a string. And then what we're looking to do is just focus on a subset of states. So let's just look at the top five with the most population. So again, I have my data frame here. I'm going to sort by the population. Ascending means from smallest to largest. It's not what we want. We want largest to smallest. So it needs to be set to false. And then we want the top five. So that would be just grabbing the head of the data frame, the first five rows. So if we run this, we now see a top five states with the largest population. No surprise here. California is number one, Texas, Florida, New York, and Pennsylvania. So what I'm going to do again is copy over some code that I had beforehand. And what we're going to be doing here is actually getting this information. So this on the state column, the 06-48-12, we want to get this to a list. That way we can pass it through our API call. So if I run this, you're going to see the top five states. It's the same exact list here. And then I'm using this over here, this join, in order to join each of the elements in the list to a single string that could then be passed, because I don't want to manually input that. So over here, essentially same exact URLs above, except something has changed here. Well, for one, we want to get the age only for 16. And if you want to get more information on the ages that are available, you can go to this variable page that we showed you before. And it says here the ages and the corresponding values here. Just another table that actually does age groups instead of just the single age, which is really useful as well. So we changed it, the age here, we're specifying it. And then for state, we're actually going to be passing in the string. So it's what it's going to look like is this. It's going to look like this. It's going to have them all inputted here. But instead I have the zero here so that I could just pass it in. So I run this and let's transform that to a data frame. And we can see now we have the population for age 16. So that's just an example of how you can specify certain values here. Lastly, let's actually try to do something where we can make a chart. Because data is great in a table, but it's always better when it can be visualized. So what if we want to see the population in New York year over year of the Hispanic population? So what we're doing here is we're setting Hispanic 1 and 2 because we want to see non-Hispanic and Hispanic. If we go back to that table and we go to this, but we could see that those are the values. One is non-Hispanic, two is Hispanic. And then we're going to set the date codes to a range of dates. It's going to be different years. We're going to add date description. And then for the states, we're just going to put 36 because that's what corresponds with New York. So we run this. And let's turn this into a data frame. We can see that it does return the data for New York split by HISP, but we want to see this in an actual table because that's more fun. So right now I'm going to be referencing Plotly. Plotly is a graphing library that's really awesome to use and it's interactive. It's not only with Python, you can use with R and I believe JavaScript as well. So it's very powerful. You can create dashboards. So right here, we're basically calling Plotly, which is up on top, Plotly Express. For those of you who maybe use Plotly in the past, it used to be a lot more complicated to use, but ever since Plotly Express, it's a really easy interface. We first start with saying what our data frame is. Our data frame in this case, I called it data frame Hispanic by year. And we're going to specify our x-axis, so going horizontally, what do we want to plot? We want to plot the state description. And then for Y, going up and down vertical, we want to be able to see the population, and we want to split it by the column HISP for Hispanic. So if I run this, not the prettiest chart, but it's still getting the point across. We could see this information broken out by each year. And if we zoom in on the non-population Hispanic, I believe that's the non-population, we could see, wait a minute, have you guys noticed something? This is all out of order. So we see 2015, 2016, 2018, 2019, 2017. So why is that? Well, this data is coming back in a string format. So in order to really plot this correctly, we would need to go in here and parse this out as a date and then plot that over here. Otherwise, this is going to come out a little bit messed up. Well, if you don't want to do all that work, I do have a solution for you. But once I get, right before I get to it, I do want to note this API call was pretty easy in terms of what the census has. So the census has a lot of different tables and they get more complicated. So for example, when we were looking at the different endpoints, which was over here, there was just two. It was US and state. However, if I were to go back to population estimates, which is a different table we have not seen before, I'm going to click it here and I'm going to look at the examples, and there's a lot of different endpoints. So it is a little bit more confusing to be able to get. However, I would not leave you with a confusing solution. So I've actually developed a wrapper on top of the Census API to make it super easy to get the data, to be able to interpret, say if you're looking for county, you don't have to, or state or region, you don't have to input all of it in this string here. You could just call it straight from my API. It's currently under development, should be released pretty soon, and it's going to be hosted on Rapid API. So if you haven't already, please subscribe to our channel so you can get the latest content in data, analytics, technology, and real estate. Thanks for watching.